Hello everyone! In this demonstration video, we're going to showcase a very powerful open source video editing framework called Lucy Edit to help you understand it better. You can think of it as the nano banana of the video domain. Now, pay close attention. When I describe this technology, I use two key terms. First, it is open source. Second, it is a framework. To put it simply, this means it is a general purpose method. The significance of this model is extraordinary. It means that within the open source community, all developers can use this framework and apply it to any model. Figuratively speaking, what this model brings us isn't just a single product, but an entire production line for product. What you are seeing now is the Lucy Edit page on Hugging Face here. We can find some key information. For instance, it is implemented based on the WAN 2.25b architecture. So, what features does it have? We can summarize them with four keywords. The first is change. We can change a person's clothing or a specific color. The second is add. We can add objects into the video. The third is replace. We can replace certain objects within the video. And the fourth is called transform to, which refers to global or overall scene changes. Additionally, the official website has rated the effectiveness of these features. Generally speaking, the best results are achieved in changing outfits, replacing characters, and replacing objects. The effects for adding objects, changing colors, and altering the overall style and scene are slightly less effective. It is also important to note that it does not have the functionality to delete objects. Please keep that in mind. Furthermore, the creators of Lucy Edit have also developed a ComfyUI extension. On this page, we can see that Lucy Edit currently offers two versions. One is the dev or developer version, and the second is the pro or professional version. The dev version is completely open source, while the pro version can only be accessed via an API. The installation process for this extension is quite standard. First, you need to clone the code repository into your custom notes folder. Then use the command pip install r requirements.txt to install all the necessary dependencies. Next up is downloading the models. Currently, Lucy Edit provides two types of models. One is FP16 and the other is FP32. You can download the one that best suits your computing power. After downloading, place the model file into your ComfyUI Modal C checkpoints directory. I have built all the workflows on runninghub.ai, which you can access through their platform. In the world of ComfyUI, RunningHub is an excellent online workbench because it keeps up with new technologies as soon as they are released. You can use the invitation link in my video description to register for RunningHub, which will give you 1,000 free credits. Plus, you get an additional 100 credits for logging in daily, allowing you to experiment with your own workflows. What you see now is the official workflow provided by the developers. You can find it on their GitHub page in the examples directory and download the second workflow file. This is the basic structure of the workflow you are looking at. Now, let's do a basic analysis of the workflow. First is loading the main model. Here, we're loading the FP16 version of the Lucy Edit model to ensure a faster sampling speed. Below that is the text encoder, which is compatible with the WAN model. Pay attention here, the VAA is slightly different since the base model is WAN 2.25b. The VAA we use is the one for WAN 2.2. This is different from when we use the 14b model, where we use the WAN 2.1 VAE. It is a small but important difference to note. Then we have some basic configurations, mainly for setting the frame rate and the total number of frames. Next, we have our source video. A woman in business attire, making a simple movement. We'll resize it. Note that the official setting is 1280x720, but I've changed it to 832x480 depending on my system's capabilities. Then we encode the original video into the latent space using the VAE. Here, the way you write the prompt is very important. Take a look at my prompt. It needs to clearly state that we are changing the white shirt and gray skirt into a hanfu, a traditional Chinese dress. The following text provides some details about the texture of the hanfu, which you can add or remove as you see fit. But the crucial part is the first sentence. You must clearly state what is being changed into what. This is key to ensuring a good final result. Before sampling, there are a few preparatory steps. There is a very important note here called Lucy condition, concat. It essentially takes our model and the encoded original video as inputs. After processing, it outputs a modified model and a latent representation. Following this is the sampling process. The sampler setup is nothing too special. We've set the steps to 50 and the CFG to 5.0. Oh, the sampler is Euler, and the scheduler is simple. After decoding, we can see the result. In the final generated video, we have successfully maintained the consistency of the character. She hasn't changed. Additionally, we've achieved precise editing of her clothing. From this workflow breakdown, you've probably realized that the most important part is how to write the prompt. What if you are not good at writing prompts? Don't worry. On the official GitHub page, there is a section on prompt engineering. This part here, it allows you to use a large language model, LM, to help generate prompts for you. So how do we do it? Just copy this entire text block. Then, choose an LLM you frequently use. I am using Gemini here. I'll switch the model to Gemini 1.5 Pro, as it is currently Google's most advanced inference model. Then, click on System Instructions and paste the text you just copied in here. Let's briefly look at this. Our input consists of two parts. First, a description of your original video. Second, your modification goal how. You want to change the video. Describing a video in text can be tedious. But we all know that Gemini is a multimodal model, meaning it can understand not just text, but also images and videos. So if writing a video description is too much trouble, we can use another method. You can upload the video directly, or just upload the first frame of the video to show the model what the video is about. For simplicity, I've just uploaded the first frame of the video here. Then I write my request, change the girl's outfit to a hanfu. And as you can see, I get a very well-written prompt. When I put this prompt into the node and run the sampler, the result is guaranteed to be good. Now let's do some other tests. For example, I can ask it to dress the girl in a suit of golden armor. It generates the corresponding prompt. And let's look at the result. The texture of the armor, the details, and the character's consistency are all perfectly maintained. Similarly, I can have her wear a flight attendant's uniform or even a bikini. It all works without any issues. Next, try something different. Let's change the girl's hair to a charming purple color. Looking at the result, the transparency and realism aren't quite there. As mentioned, the model performs best at changing clothes and replacing objects. For changing colors, the performance is just average. That is why the purple hair looks a bit fake, with a strong plastic-like texture. Now for a full background replacement, we'll change the background to a sunset beach. The result is fantastic. The waves, the sunset ambience, the character consistency, and her clothes everything remains unchanged while the background is completely new. Moreover, the overall lighting and shadows have been completely reconstructed to match the new scene. Let's try adding an object. We will add a majestic bald eagle to the girl's shoulder. Again, the LLM generates a prompt for us. Let's see the result. The effect of the bald eagle is quite good. While there isn't much movement, you'll notice that the shadows are simulated very well. Now for a replacement. We will replace her glasses with a cat face mask. The mask itself looks fine, but its aesthetic appeal is debatable. Finally, let's do a complete character replacement. We will change the girl into Superwoman using the generated prompt. Let's look at the result. It is also very impressive. The character's features, the superhero costume, the iconic logo. Notice that the entire character has been swapped out. Even her hair color has changed. This shows that the replacement effect is excellent. Through these demonstrations, I believe you now have an intuitive understanding of this model. We can't say its effects are absolutely perfect yet, but remember, what this model provides us with is a method. It is currently based on the 1.2.25b model. If it were based on the 14b version, we could achieve even better results. Because as we mentioned earlier, this is more than just a model, it is a general purpose methodology. All right, that is all for today. What are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it for yourself. Follow me and become an AI expert.